Myself, Angita Tiwari, from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology, from IT Accelerator Department. I'm going to take a session from the subject that is Computer Vision. Subject code is 3171614. The module that we are going to cover is module number 3, Feature Detection is the module name. The topic that we are going to cover for this session is Morphological Operations. So the various morphological operations that we are having it, we are going to discuss it. So with respect to that, we are going to discuss first of all what is mathematics, that is, or morphology, because morphology is with respect to we have different set theory operations or the logical operations that we have in mathematics. So it is used to extract, we can say, image components that are useful in the representation and the description of the region shape, that is like boundaries extractions that we have with respect to the boundaries. Then we have skeletons. With respect to particular skeleton, its image, structure, shapes, okay. Then we have convex hull property, concave hull properties, okay. Then we have morphological filtering that we are going to discuss, the basic operations that we have in morphology. Then we have thinning. Thinning is with respect to the shrinking part or the erosion part that we are having it in the morphological operations part. Pruning, with respect to the growing phase. So these are the different regions, we can say different regions where we are going to represent, we can say describing the region shape that we have for a particular area. Okay, so moving forward, the mathematical framework that is used for the morphology is pre-process. Whenever we are processing a particular image, that is image processing, we need to do the pre-processing of a particular image. So pre-processing part. Then we have noise filtering. Okay, that is shape simplification that we have with respect to noise. Because whenever we are taking an image with respect to the noise, we are removing that noise part from that image by making the pixels brighter or darker. Okay, then enhancing the object structure that we have. Okay, enhancing means changing the properties of the object structures in order to make it more suitable for the visibility mode. Okay, then skeletonization, that is convex hull property that we have already discussed. So it is used for these of the applications. Then segmentation. This is our next chapter itself. Okay, so segmentation is what with respect to the bifurcations of a particular quadrant in the four of the quadrants and making the analysis of it. Then watershed. Okay, so we are having different properties, then we have quantitative descriptions as well in order to define the framework for the mathematical part that we are going to use for the morphology. Okay, then the area means parameter, that is area square. Okay, then we have parameters that we are going to use for a particular area. Okay, so these are the different mathematical areas that we are going to use, or the mathematical frameworks that we are going to use for the morphology. Okay, a set of, we can say it is a set of mathematical morphology that will represent object in an image. Okay, what binary? What image? So binary image where 0 stands for white and 1 stands for black. We already know that. So the element of the set is the coordinate, that is x and y value of a pixel, which will belong to the object, that is z square for a 2D form. Okay, the same thing, grayscale images that we have, the element of the set is the coordinate, that is x and y of a pixel, which belong to the object, and the grayscale levels, which is belonging to the z cube of the function. So two of the functions which is defined, that is z square and z cube for a particular morphology image. Okay, so we have different morphological operations. Okay, we will be going to discuss, we will be seeing the operations, what we are going to do in that operations. The first we have erosion, shrink. Okay, as you can see in the image as well, shrinking means image, then shrink. Okay, then we have dilation. Okay, means grow. Okay, small to grow big. Okay, then we have combination, to like opening to the object and closing to the background. So we will be having the two of the process, that is erosion and dilution, and the combination will be the opening and the closing part with respect to the object and with respect to the background. So we can see keep the general shape but smooth it with respect to the two of the operation, that is opening and the closing. So these are the two of the operations in the mixed part. Okay, now we are going to discuss each and every operation that we have. Erosion. So does the structuring element fit into the set? Very big question arises. So the erosion of a set, we can see A, by structuring the element B, all the Z in A such that B is in A, where the origin, that is we can say B is equals to Z. So it will shrink the object. How? With the property or with the function, that is AX. It's a symbolic notation, that is circle with a symbol, that is dash, which is equal to Z. It's a function, that it's a value, that is X and Y, with respect to the function, that is B, which is in set A, which is a subset and the equal also. Subset also and equal also. Subset is a symbolic relation that I have shown you with respect to A. So this is what, how it will shrink the object. So here it is the diagram. We are having the image. Okay, and how it has been taken with respect to the SE, where the two or four of the diagonal cases, we have taken it with respect to the point which is in middle. We have been showing it. Okay, with respect to the all of the diagram here I have taken. See, pixel I have taken with respect to a box structure with a cross value. So that pixels has been taken individually as an SE, like one pixel and the other four of the sides. Okay, now dilation. So does the structuring element hit the set? It's a question for the dilation. Okay, so here the answer, dilation of a set A, it is used by doing the structuring element, that is B. So all of the Z elements in A such that the B hits A when the origin of B is equal to Z. So it will grow the object. Okay, how it will grow? It's a function A, X or B, the symbolic notation, where Z is being taken. And Z is being taken with the property of B with respect to Z, that is intersection A, which is not equal to 5. Which is not equal to 5 means it is having a particular value, okay, with respect to which is hitting into the image. Okay, how it has been hitting, as you can see here, whenever it will hit means a particular, all of the location is being taken. Now with respect to that, you have to grow it. Okay, we do not have to select it. Means growing means it will select all the pixels, other sides also. So here, as you can see, one pixel, so all of the pixels has been taken into consideration. So this has been shown with respect to the SE, as you can see here. Okay, then we have advantages, compulsory with respect to origin and with respect to the two second of, that is dilation. So erosion, it will remove the structures of the certain shape and size given by SE that we have. And mean dilation, filling of the holes, means the holes which are left it out. Okay, it will fill it by certain shape and size given by the SE, which is the module that we have. We have to extract it. Okay, the next, the we can say combination of these two, erosion and dilation, is been given with respect to the opening and the closing. So opening, erosion which is followed by dilation, that is denoted by symbolic notation. Okay, which is defined by eliminate, that is protrusions, eliminate protrusions and breaks the necks, smooths the contour, and we can see with the diagram as well, sorry, with the formula as well, that is A, O, okay, dot we can say, circle we can say, B which is equals to A minus, that is erode function, which has been applied with respect to the dilation. Okay, so A and B, erosion with respect to, after that, dilation with the B. So this is what the function is with respect to opening, that is erosion, which is followed by dilation property, which will eliminate protrusions, breaks the necks and smooths the contour value, which we are taking it for a particular color combination. So here B which has been taken and A which has been taken with respect to B, that is B, S and Y with respect to A. Okay, and A here with respect to the different properties that we have taken in A place. Okay, and after that we are doing the two of the things. Okay, first of all we are doing the erosion. Okay, A, X or B, and then dilation, that is A, X or X not B. Okay, X or B. So the two of the forms, combining it, and we will get the image which is, I have been taken with the form of cross. Okay, so this is what the thing is with respect to opening part. Then the last form that we have is closing, that is dilation. Okay, which is being followed by the erosion, which is denoted by dot. Okay, so here it, what it will do, first of all, it will smooth the contour. Okay, after smoothing the contour, it will fuse the narrow breaks and long thin curves. Okay, after that, what it will do? It will eliminate the small holes that we have for the particular erosion part. Okay, and then it will fill the gaps in the contour, the color combination that we are taking. So we can say with the formula is A dot B, which is equal to A. First of all, that is dilation, A XOR B. With respect to that property which has been done, after that we are doing the erosion, that is circle, with respect to the minus, and which is with, followed by the B. So it will smooth the contour, it will fuse the narrow break that we have and the long thin curves that we have, and it will eliminate the small holes and it will fill the gaps in the contour. Okay, so these are the steps that we need to, so these are the properties that it has been given for the dilation and which is being followed by the other of the properties. Okay, so the two of the things that which has been matched. Okay, so after that we have that B is being given with respect to the edges. Okay, that is point is being taken with respect to the B and all of the corners with respect to all of the point, and the A which is being taken with an image. Okay, the pixel points that we have. Now here we are taking the dilation first and then erosion. Okay, in opening we are taking the erosion first and then dilation, but here the dilation first and then erosion. So here the size will increase. Okay, means it will dilate it. It will increase the size with respect to all the pixel positions that we have. Okay, so this is what the thing is that we are following for the morphological operation of the closing part. So both of the operations will be including with respect to the two of the main properties, that is erosion and dilation, which is shrink, it will shrink the value and it will dilate the grow the value. So two of the properties with respect to two of the operations and the combination of these two. Okay, so these are the different morphological operations that you have studied so far in this video lecture, the four of the operations: dilation, erosion, opening and closing. So these are the morphological operations that we have seen with respect to the mathematical calculation or the formula that we have mathematically with respect to A and B set theory properties. So here we are completing the morphological operations. The next topic we are going to do in the next session. Thank you.